In this video, I'm going to go over rounding by example. When you are rounding, every place value that you take a look at in decimal notation or as an integer or signed number will always have these digits right here. So we have always utilized these digits in all the place values. Now, the first you'll notice we have 10 digits in total. So we have, this is the first half of the digit. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. And then we have our upper digits, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And there's 5 on each side there. And the way that rounding works, if the digit is between 0 and 4, we do not change anything. And when it is between 5 and 9, we one up. So I will show that by example. And hopefully by seeing all of these examples, you will have a better idea on how to round. Let's start. The first example that we have, which is 248, asks us to round to the 10. We have to find that place value, so 10 is right here. And the way that rounding works, all it does is it looks at the digit, the place value, right next door, and in this case it's 8, and notice that 8 is on the upper half, so it is greater than 5, and therefore we will increase our 4 by 1. That's what I mean by one up. So my answer here will be 2. The 4 has now changed to a 5, and all remaining digits will get zeroed off. And that is 248 rounded to the 10, which was right here for this question. It's the first example. Let's continue on. So hopefully that slowly it starts to make more sense to you. The second example asks us to round to the 10,000. So we have to find the 10,000 first. So we have ones, tens, hundreds, thousands, and there we have it. So 10,000ths is the 5. Now, again, rounding only looks at the digit next to it on the right-hand side. That's a 3. 3 is now between 0 and 4. So we just keep the 5 as it is. It doesn't get to go up by 1, which makes the answer 4 or 5, and then we zero off all the other digits. And that's the rounded answer for the second question. Let's take a look at the third question. So in the third question, we have a number that we're supposed to round to the 100. So the 100 is right here. We have a 9. Next door to it, again, we have a 9. So we're going to increase the 9, which is highlighted, by 1. But if you increase it by 1, it turns out to be 10. And we cannot write a 10 in there. So we carry this 1 over to the 8. And that 8 now increases. So it becomes 9. That original 9 was 10 or 0. And we zero off everything else. So whenever you do have a 9 and it will get increased by 1, it does carry to the next digit over. Let's take a look at something similar in example 4. Example 4 wants us to round to the 10, which is the second digit there. Now, there is a 9 right next door to it, which means that this will turn into a 10. And like the previous question, I can't write a 10 in there, so that 1 will carry over. Okay, and again, you notice that if it carries over, there's another 9. So that turns into a 10, and it carries over again. And here's another 9. So the 1 will keep carrying until finally, okay, we can increase the number, and that 1 will be a 2, and everything else has turned into zeros. So that's an interesting one that happens in rounding if you do run into nines. Let's take a look at example 5. Now this one is a little tricky and sometimes a little mean if someone gives it to you, but it may happen. So for instance, notice the question asks us to round to the 100, but there is no 100. Because the 100 is right here. Now, technically, the number in front there is really a zero. So we treat the rounding exactly the same way, meaning we look to the right of the 100 place. It's a 4. Now, 4 is less than 5. So we won't do anything with the zero right here. So it will just remain zero. And we're supposed to, in rounding, to zero off everything else, but these zeros just turn it into zero. So the way that you can think of it, since we wanted to round to the 100, we would need something 50 or above in order to round it up to the 100. But we were under the 50, and therefore it rounded down for us to that zero that you see there. Okay, as a contrast, notice the second one, which is now 55, so question 6, it's asking us to do the same thing, but now the difference is, so the zero in this 100 place, it looks and sees a 5 right here, but the digit 5 or above will increase that 0 by 1. And now that turns it into 100. Okay, let's try some rounding when we have decimals. So it's no different with decimals. Okay, but let's see what can happen when you do have a decimal. So the first one, question 7, asks us to round to the 10th, which is right here. And now I look next door, it's a 2. Well, 2 is less than 5, so I will do nothing with the 9. It will just remain as it is. So here, okay, we will round it to the 10th. And what I want you to notice is, unlike with the whole numbers above, where we would zero off, so we would zero off these, we don't zero off here because we want to end at the place value that they asked us to, and that was the 10th. So our answer will just remain 8.9. Let's take a look at question 8. In question 8, we want to round to the 100th. The 100th is the 9 right there. And now I look next door, which is an 8. And like the previous questions that we ran into, well, the 8 is going to increase the 9 by 1 to a 10. So that's going to carry the 1 over to the other side. So So this becomes 14.2. And I will put in the 0 here because it did ask us to round to the 100th. And this is the 100th place. So that 0 I will keep. But I will not put any other further zeros because that would have been a different place value. Let's take a look at question 9. So it wants us to round to the 10th, which is right here. We look next door. It's very similar to the previous question. So it's an 8. So now rounding again. So my 1 is going to start carrying over, except it's going to carry over all the way to that 1, which is going to increase to a 2. This becomes a 0. And because we want to round to the 10th, I'm also going to put a 0 here so that I remain in the 10th spot. And the rest will be removed. And the last question now, rounding to the 1,000th. So we have here the tenths, hundredths, thousandths right here. I will look next door. It's a 1, so I will not do anything with the 3. And the answer will be 0.043. And I stop. With that 3, okay, because that's the 1,000th place value. So you have seen 10 different examples of place values, and hopefully you found this useful with the rounding. Thank you for watching.